Student, welcome to online tutorial session. I hope that you have seen the video lecture regarding the chapter 2 operating system. So today we will solve the exercise part, okay, under the summative assessment. So number A, the question is that put a tick mark on the correct options. Okay, so the first question is, dash programs are used to carry out the routine tasks that are often needed by the user. So option is application software, word processing software, operating system and utilities. The correct answer is D, it is utilities. Number two, the Windows, Unix and Linux are the name of computer books, operating system, application software or utilities. The correct option is B, operating system. Number three, with command line interface, the user has to type a command, select icon, speak out the commands and choose the commands on the screen. So you know that the correct answer is A, type commands. Number four, the Linux is an application software, operating system for network environment, open source operating system and software owned by the company. So the correct answer is for this question is number C, open source operating system. So all of you get this answer. Now coming to the B part. Okay, so B part is saying that answer the following question in brief. The first question is, what is an operating system and write down the name of any two popular operating systems. So an operating system is a means of communication between the user and the computer and it manages the operation inside the computer. So what are those examples? The examples are MS-DOS, Linux and Unix. Okay. Now coming to the next question, that is distinguish between CLI and CUI. Okay, though in your book it is written CUI, it is not CUI, it is CLI because it is command line interface. Okay, so first point is that CLI is difficult to use and GUI whereas it is easy to use. In case of CLI, it consumes low memory while in case of GUI, it is consumes much more memory. In CLI, we can obtain high precision while in it we have low precision. CLI is faster than GUI. The speed of a GUI is slower than CLI. CLI operating system needs only keyboard while the operating system GUI operating system needs both keyboard as well as mouse. Okay. So now next is number five is the CLI operating systems. CLI appearance cannot modify, it can change, okay, but while its appearance it can be modified and can change in case of GUI. Next point, in CLI inputs is entered only at a command prompt, but while in case of GUI input can be entered anywhere on the screen. Okay, in CLI the information is shown and presented to the user in a plain text and files. But while in case of GUI, the information shown in the presented to the user in a format such as plain text, video, images, etc. Many more options we are getting it over here. Now in CLI, there are no minuses provided while here in case of GUI, a minus is provided. Number 10 is there is no graphics in CLI, but here in GUI you are able to see the graphics, that is the icon, you are seeing the symbol, so the graphics is there. CLI do not use any pointing device, but here in the GUI we are using the pointing device mouse to select the different icon and everything. Number 12, that in CLI spelling mistake and typing errors are not avoided. But whereas in GUI, spelling mistake and any typing error is avoided over here. Okay, so there are 12 points I have mentioned over here. Just try to learn and remember all those 12 points, because if it is coming as a long question, then for 5 marks or something, so you have to write down all those points over here. Okay, 12 points. Okay, now coming to the next question. That is, what is an open source operating system? Give an example. Okay, so open source operating system is a software with a source code that anyone can inspect, modify and enhance. Okay, it is not mandatory that you have to write down only this definition in your book. Another definition is not actually a definition in your book. So it is written, and as the name suggested, the code of open source software is open to everybody. We can do anything with the software, including modifying and sharing it. So this definition from the book you can learn and write, and whatever definition I have mentioned over here also, that also you can write as an answer. Okay, so the concept of open source is that actually operating systems are the set of the programs. Okay, the set of the programs, we are how we are writing programs. The program is designed by using the writing the codes. So in case of code, there can be modification can be done. So the permission are granted for, in case of Linux, can be granted by the user. The user can modify the code and change it. Okay, so this prohibition is there. But in case of other kind of operating system software, the program code we cannot change. Okay, it only change at the developer and the company who developed this particular system, the programs, they only can change. User cannot change. But in case of open source operating system, the phenomenon is that user who is actually installing this particular operating system can do the necessary changes if required. Okay, so the example is very popular one, that is a Linux is an example of open source operating system. Okay, now next is that write the functions of the operating system. Okay, though in your book it is written, write down the four function of an operating system. Don't learn only four, because it may comes under the broad question. So that's why you just write down the learn and all the points over here. Okay, so I have taken the points from your book only. Okay, so operating system provides the user interface. From the definition itself, you have learned that interface, it is an interface so that your user can interact with the computer. Number two, it manages computer hardware such as printer. Only printer name is there, but many hardware, whatever is associated with the computer, it is controlled and manipulated by this only operating system. Accept data from the input device and transfer to the computer's memory. Next, four, it manages the application that are running on the computer. Whatever application programs is running, if you don't have this operating system in your computer, then you cannot install the application software, because application software needs this operating system. Okay, now it allocates the memory space to the program and data. Whatever information and everything our programs are storing and something, the storage also be available by this operating system. It manages files, helping us to save our or organize the file, find files, everything regarding file loading, opening, saving, modifying, everything can be taken care of by this operating system. Okay, it manages the computer's memory, deciding what should be loaded into the memory, what should be removed. It's in case of operating system, it might happen that as a whole, as a all instruction, we don't need it. Okay, at the time of processing, so few part of a process or few part of information we need at this point of time, so it is taken up from there, from the memory, and we are working on it. After this part of this memory work is finished, then it is again removed, and another next part of the next part of the information is taken up from the memory. So this thing also be done over here. Okay, and another thing is that so it deals with any error that occurs when the program is being run. If there is any program error is showing, so it will show you the error message, or it will help you out and which things you have to click and what are the next step you can do. Okay, next nine, it looks after the computer security, preventing unauthorized access of the system. Okay, so this is all about this operating system, function of the operating system. So next, fifth and the last question is that what are utilities, and give two examples. Okay, so here in your book, the utility definition is not at all properly written. So that's why just learn this point. So utility programs, commonly referred to as just utilities, are the software programs that added functionality to your computer or help your computer to perform it better. So what are the functionalities are helping, that is compressing the file to save on the backing up storage, recovering the data from the damaged file, checking the disk for the fault or repairing them, checking the files on the disk computer for virus, defragmenting the disk, fragmentation and compression both can be done, and formatting the floppy disk. These are the part of the work is done by this utility program. Okay, I hope all the answers is clear. Please timely submit your copy so that I can check down your copy. Okay, thank you, student. I'm ending my lecture over here.